Hello and welcome guys. In this tutorial, let's discuss how to install cPanel and Azure VM. To introduce Azure on high level, Microsoft Azure is one of the leading cloud solution provider. Many corporate organizations prefer Azure for their robust infrastructure and their supreme support. For this demonstration, I will create a new VM. If you want to skip this part, please follow the timeline present in the description. After logging to your Azure portal, from the left hand menu, please select virtual machines as shown in the image. Once you are in the virtual machine page, please click on the create and select virtual machine option from the drop down menu. Azure will take you to create a virtual machine page. We need to provide few details to Azure such that the VM needs to be created on which subscription, which resource group, and kind of the details which is asking for, like virtual machine name, region, availability set. Most important part is the image one. Click on see all images text, which would take you to Azure marketplace to select your custom image. Here in the search bar, please type cPanel and WHM. As you can see, we have four results here. The first one is the image which is provided by cPanel itself. It is asking to bring your own license. The other image has 5 licenses and it would charge £0.02 per hour, and it is provided by Media 3 Tech LLC. The next version is Pro version, which comes with 30 licenses and the cost would be £0.15 per hour. The last option is Premier Edition, which comes with 30 licenses and it will cost 0.2 pounds per hour. For this demonstration, I will select cPanel image. Again, it has two options to select from. I am selecting the first one. We are not going to install cPanel on Ubuntu in this demonstration, so I will select the first one. Once the image is selected, we will continue to configure our VM. You need to select the size and also the authentication type. For the authentication type, I would opt for password, and few of the keywords like root are reserved by Azure. It doesn't allow us to create a root user. Once this part is done, I would leave rest of the things to default and click on review plus create button. Now Azure will perform the validations of the configurations which we have requested for. Let's give it a minute. If everything goes fine, you will see a validation passed notification at the top and create button at the bottom. I'll go ahead and click on create button. This should take some time and eventually create the VM which we requested for. So this is the deployment screen. And if you observe, Azure has created NSG first, which is network security group, and then has assigned an IP to the VM, and then added network interface, which is NIC, and finally the VM provisioning step has started. Again, it will take a minute. There we go, our VM is ready, and you can see your deployment is complete message and the notification. I would click on go to resource, and here is the details of our new provision VM. One thing I want to show is I'll go to networking, and as you can see, the advantage of using cPanel image, the ports whatever cPanel and WHM uses for the smooth functioning are already open. So this is one less headache for us if we opt for cPanel image. As soon as I SSH to the server, cPanel installation begins. So we have nothing to do here. As soon as you SSH, the cPanel kicks off its installation process and you just sit back and relax until this is done. If you don't want to see all the logs, what's actually happening while the installation process is running, you can simply hit Ctrl C so that the installation routes to shell, and once the installation is finished, you can just simply execute a command which is sudo whm login, which would generate a new temporary session where you would get a URL, just copy paste, and you can continue the installation continue the configuration of your WHM from the browser. And if you are like me to see what's actually happening on my server, just monitor the logs, and there we go. We have reached or finished our installation process, and WHM cPanel URL has been generated. Copy paste the URL in the browser and you can continue configuring your WHM and cPanel. That's all. This is how we install cPanel and WHM and Azure VM. Thanks for watching. If you like the content, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. See you soon. Have a good day ahead. Bye.